call the meeting to order. If everyone would rise to pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you guys for coming. Sorry that we had a mishap last time, so sorry if you guys came with me too. Sorry about that.
Sorry,
There are several emergencies at night, so we apologize for any inconvenience it might have caused. Next on the agenda is the roll call. Let the minutes show that four members are here, with Heather Stewart being absent. Next is the approval of the agenda. First by Kyle. Discussions or questions? Is there a second?
I'll second.
Second by Stacy. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion passes 4-0. Moving into informational items. First is the participation enrollment report. Bob, I guess you go first.
All right. This is be pretty brief. Our year ended up with all three schools topping the month previous in participation percentage, even though that only accounts for a few days of the very end of the school year then. But also, we ended our enrollment exactly where we began. I thought that was kind of interesting. So, all in all, pretty good school year, but we're again glad to be back to regular old attendance for next year.
Have we had any new kids enrolling yet for next year?
Kindergartners, for sure. Yeah already. July 1st, we'll start to see the beginning of the new crop start to come in grades 1 through 12.
Gotcha.
What's the attendance for the summer?
Sorry?
What's the attendance been for summer?
Michelle, any ideas on that?
We had about 100 that came, consistently. I have 149 that signed up, but there would be dentist appointments and doctor's appointments and basketball camp and all kinds of stuff. So they were kind of fluid, but it was pretty consistently close to 100.
Primarily elementary?
I mean, yeah, but there was a good amount of middle school, which I was surprised by. I was shocked at how much they loved it. Parents kept saying, this is great, I love this, that they're enjoying themselves, they want to come back every day. Teachers were happy too, really happy.
Any other questions for Rob? Thank you, Rob. Next is personnel. Did everyone get a chance to look at personnel? All right, next is the superintendent's expense report. Did everyone get a chance to look at that? Next would be the data security and privacy policy for the 2021-2022. Everybody look at that? Sorry, I was pulling it up. Any questions on that? Okay, next is the discussion of transportation procedures.
Board members, we have talked about this a couple different times. I'm recommending that we remove any language from our code of conduct that pertains to bus passes or transportation procedures, because they're not disciplinary issues. They don't pertain to the code of conduct. At my request, Chris put together the one-page guide, which you've seen a couple different times and is in your board book tonight. So you're all aware of my recommendation on this. I just want to stress one thing. We will absolutely work with parents who have emergencies. We do have some families in our district who are either single parents or have blended families, and we will make every effort to work with those people. That I feel like we need to take some type of step to limit the what can only be described as excessive bus passes that have been issued at our elementary for years. It's put up some kids in a very difficult situation a couple times, and you're all aware of that. It's put the district in a tenuous position. So I'm making this recommendation for the safety of our kids, to protect the school district, but want to assure the board, we will work with our parents. They're our customers, and we will work with them in cases of emergencies, so.
Any questions for Dr. Baker or Chris?
Chris, I think you did a great job. The last meeting where the presentation was made, I think that was excellent. Thank you.
Thank you.
I think it's a problem that's needed to be solved for a while, and I appreciate the effort.
There is no audience of citizens. So moving on to recommended board motions. Approval of the minutes for 5/27/21.
I'll make it.
First by David. Discussions or questions? Is there a second? Second by Kyle. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion passes 4-0. Next is approval of the minutes for the 6/10/2021.
I'll make it.
First by Kyle. Discussions or questions? Is there a second?
Make it.
Second by David. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion passes 4-0. Next is approval of the treasurer's report.
I'll make it.
First by Kyle. Discussions or questions? Is there a second?
I'll second.
Second by Stacy. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion passes 4-0. Next is approval of the order of the treasurer for bills.
I'll make it.
First by Stacy. Any questions or concerns?
I can try.
Is there a second?
I'm in.
Second by Kyle. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
Aye.
Motion passes 3-1. Next is the approval of insurance carrier for the fleet, property, general liability, umbrella, and workers' compensation.
I'll make it.
First by David. Any questions? Is there a second? Second by Kyle. All in favor? Is that yes, David?
Yes.
Okay, awesome. Motion passes 4-0. Next is the approval for an additional business teacher at the Walton Vernon High School.
I'll make it.
First by Kyle. Discussions or questions? Is there a second?
I'll make it.
Second by Stacy. All in favor? All opposed?
Aye.
Motion passes 3-1. Next is the approval of the creation of the varsity lacrosse head coach and assistant coach positions.
I'll make it.
First by Kyle. Discussions or questions? Is there a second?
I'll make it.
Second by Stacy. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion passes 4-0. Next is approval of amended 2021-2022 salary schedule.
I'll make it.
First by Kyle. Discussions or questions?
I just had a few things with this. Really, I think the salary schedule is largely fine, with the exception of the PM athletic complex supervisor. I don't believe that this is necessary. I don't believe that it's the best option for the district. I'm also uncomfortable with the idea of giving someone essentially free housing and free utilities, no tax liability in the district. We have plenty of teachers who don't live in the district either because they can't afford to, or they don't want to pay that tax liability, and I don't think that this is a great option. I'm not sure why this is the option that's being proposed, but that part of the salary schedule, I have an issue with personally.
Well, just to kind of respond, David, to some of your concerns, and I respect that. I shared information with the board. I did look at, you know, other options, the fiber optics option with the security cameras, and that is very expensive. If we do that work now, we have to essentially write a check for that and pay for it out of general fund. If we do that work, if and when we build a school at the complex, we can bond it, and it doesn't affect the general fund as much. I realize that's an expensive option. The only other option that I can think of would be to not have someone at the complex install a great deal of security fencing and lock it down and not leave that open to the community. I will tell you that I was over there on Sunday about 3 or 4 in the afternoon and was shocked at the number of people that were over there. I think if we close the complex to the community, I think we would all hear about that. So I'm just uncomfortable having that school property unattended and open to whomever 24/7 in an area that's not densely populated, that is close to the interstate, with all of the potential over there for destruction, liability, theft, all of it, I'm uncomfortable with that. And as your superintendent, this is the recommendation that I'm making. And I get what you're saying, I respect your opinion, but it's...
My opinion is that person works pretty much 7 days a week. I mean, they don't have an off day. They're opening and closing, you know, they deal with not just the high school sports, but the youth. They deal with all kinds of stuff, and I think what we're paying them, I don't think they're getting a free pass. I mean,
they're essentially getting a $30,000 raise to take this position when you factor in the in-kind benefits of, and you know much better than I do, what rent would cost to live in Verona. I'm assuming we're talking $1,000 to $1,500 a month for somebody to live somewhere there.
How many hours do you think they're working? I mean, that's the thing, like, you know, and I know there's a different breakdown versus, and it's something that we've already been doing. It's not like it's a new thing. I know they're changing things around, but it's not like we weren't already doing this. I would definitely be opposed to going through the whole thing and putting a building and all that, but maybe you get somebody out there that's irritated and they go four-wheeling through that field or tear up that turf or destroy our track, just break into the concession stand. That's what kids do. I think it's minor in comparison of what we could face. And unfortunately, we don't have high speed. And, you know, right now, I think there's like 3 Boone County sheriffs that are running all county. So the chances of that being monitored is pretty much slim to none. So I think that it's a safety net. I think it's a...
We don't have somebody living in the elementary school. Everybody lives here.
But we don't have community members using the elementary and this campus. We don't have kids coming over to play on the soccer field, to run on the track, to pass football, to kick field goals, to do all those things. It's about traffic. It's about proximity to the interstate. It's in an area that is not densely populated.
You can't see it. You can see this.
Mm-hmm. I mean, correct me if I'm wrong. It was my understanding. I mean, I know I was on the board when we built it, but I remember Doc telling me we made a deal with Boone County that would be open. Like they gave us money or gave us some part of the land or whatever. Like, that has to be open to the public, from what I understand. Kevin, you guys were here. Am I wrong in it? Like, I felt like there was a deal with Boone County, like, yes, we'll participate or donate or give you money, but this is for everybody to use.
When that property was purchased, that was before I worked here, so I'm not familiar with any deals. I will say this, like, the county's relationship after they put in the road to get back there has pretty much been, like, we'll pay some money to come and mow the practice part of the fields and like push all behind the baseball field and stuff, and they're pretty hands off. Other than that, so
no, but I mean, like, you would just allow the general public to.
But yeah, so they were part of the money that was cleared. There was some fiscal court money that was used to, you know, cut off the hills and fill the valleys over there to kind of create the fields as they are, because that was all hill and trees,
right.
You know, back in the day. So yeah, I don't have a copy of like whatever agreement, but.
I just remember we talked about something, it could have been my first year, something about like shutting it down like after its practices or not opening it until at 3 o'clock, and Doc said we couldn't because it had to be open to the public because that was part of the...
Of the parks.
Right,
yeah,
the parks.
Could be.
Yeah. That's what I just was hoping you all remember. I still don't remember, but I do remember that part of it, that like there was a reason we had to open it to the public because it was part of the park system or whatever.
Do other schools have people that live, like, does Newport Independent, do they have somebody who lives at their field?
They do not. The population density in Newport is quite different than it is in Verona.
I know when I went to sign the kit, we did, you know, years ago. I don't know if they do now, but they did.
In all these years, I've not heard of someone. chasing people away from there now. Just the whole concept of having somebody live there and that being the solution, being the best solution that we can come up with is, it's just troubling for me. And the other thing that I would add is, I don't know the legal ins and outs of this, but it feels like we couldn't approve this tonight if we wanted to, because this is a new position we've created.
It's not a new position.
There's somebody out there now.
We currently have a PM athletic complex position.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah, it's Tom.
He's been there forever.
And it's called PM athletic position.
Since.
We've not approved it before.
Yeah, he's been there since they built the football field.
Yeah, I know he works there. I'm just questioning.
He lives there, yes.
One of the things we're doing tonight on the salary scale is we are eliminating one salary, correct, Kevin?
Yeah, the athletic complex supervisor, I think, is what it was called on there. I always know it on the stuff that I sent out.
And we are for significantly less money, I would add.
Well, careful, because we're changing that money around, right?
Changing that money around.
I mean, we're splitting one job into two jobs essentially.
I don't think so. I think what we're doing is appropriate. Otherwise, I wouldn't be recommending it.
Yeah, the ones doing maintenance and doing some other stuff.
So right now we kind of have like a full-time athletic complex person and a part-time maintenance person, and so we're going to a full-time maintenance. Who's going to also take on some responsibilities with an extra half time, if you will, like cutting grass and stuff that goes on in the complex. And then so that part is taken away from the athletic complex supervisor, which you used to have, and it's basically just like stuff in the after hours, opening the field, closing the gate, locking up for the night on the weekends, that kind of stuff. And so, the duties are kind of switching roles, but it's not... not an additional position as far as I'm concerned.
And I don't know the answer to this, but if we change the duties or the job description, is that something that the board typically reviews?
We're not.
Kevin just said that we were.
We're not changing the duties of this position. It's still a person who's going to be at the complex, who's going to provide supervision after hours and on the weekends. And we've had that.
Kevin just said that the position also included other duties that were taken
from putting in. Yeah, I mean, they were kind of, that position was responsible for taking care of, like, cutting the ball fields and stuff, and that won't be, in a typical sense, unless somebody's on vacation or something, that won't be a part of that training, so it has less duties than it did, but...
Every job description that the board has approved and every contract that we have in place, both the last item is always, and other duties is assigned by the supervisor. So are there some minor modifications to the duties that are assigned by the supervisor? Yes, there are. Is that specifically noted in the job description that the board has approved? Yes, it is.
And then the only other question I had was, are we, as a board, or is the district liable for any tax liabilities on this, or is that the responsibility of the individual who has the job?
I don't think the board has ever been liable for any tax liabilities.
I'm talking about from a payroll point of view.
Not that I'm aware. I mean, we'll pay taxes on the stipend amount, as will the employee. Are you referring to like the rental piece of it?
Yeah, so they'd be getting free rent and free utilities, and so
yeah,
that's compensation.
That would be up to the employee to claim on their taxes.
Okay.
That's the same as it's been for years.
Right, and
I have the same.
Just because it's been done a certain way forever doesn't mean you continue to do it, right?
Yeah. I mean,
that's a quote from you.
It is.
But I agree.
I'm just saying, as far as the tax liability, like, it'd be the same liability we've had for a few years, so.
Right, but it's, at least to my satisfaction, it's never been.
So I guess my question is what is your proposal?
My proposal would be to have different alternatives. I feel like we've been given the choice between two options, and we have to pick one of these two, in my opinion, bad options. Okay, the third one then would be putting in beds. But I didn't see that as a proposal. Like, the two that I saw were fire or the having somebody live there.
Well, what would your other proposal be? What would you propose?
Well, I don't know that we need cameras. I don't know. I haven't spent the time looking into what else we could do because that's not really my position. My position here is to look over, you know, the district and the taxpayer dollars and what we're doing for the children and how this benefit education, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. If, you know, 2-3 years ago somebody said, hey, David, go off and figure this out, like, I would have spent some time, but it wasn't something like, you know, a month ago, I think, is the first that we heard that here's what we're doing.
So you don't think there needs to be anything out there is kind of what I'm hearing you say?
I'm not sure. I'm not convinced that we need something out there.
So you're, so...
I don't know what the answer is. I feel like...
Right, but like, have you not seen, like, in the news and on over the past few years that the kids, not even saying Walton Verona kids are going, we're getting ready to play a big game, and they came down on their fields and turfed their fields and just put big holes in them doing donuts. Like, those things are happening in other schools and other districts. Yes, they're down south or whatever, maybe not in Newport, where they're going to be able to lit up like the Cincinnati
right,
guy,
right off 471.
Right. We're back here in a holler or in an off of inner city, especially if the lights aren't, you can't see anything. I think we need something, 100% something, and at this point in time, this would be the cheapest option. We already have the building, it's already there. The only thing we're doing, we're lowering the rent, someone else is going to do the maintenance. I don't know how many times that the kids are up there later or earlier or whatever to where.
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing, too. Like, when we leave, you know, if football plays 2 or 3 hours away, those kids' cars and stuff are all up there all night long. And they get locked in. Like, I mean, that's a big liability. And I mean, it's totally different for here. You've got houses back there that are locked in this back lot. And you've got passerbys going through here. And unfortunately, back there, you don't have anything that you can rely on. I mean, you can hope maybe the people that live back there, but What's that to them? So, and I don't think we're paying them that much.
All right, anything else?
Nope, nothing for me.
Thank you. Is there a second on the motion?
Who made the first?
You.
I'll second.
Second by Stacy. All in favor? All opposed?
Aye.
Motion passes 3-1. Next is approval of the Walton Verona Independent School District Trauma Informed Care Plan.
I'll make it.
First by David. Discussions or questions? Is there a second?
Mm-hmm.
Second by Kyle. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion passes 4-1. Next is the first reading of the KSBA policy recommendations for 2021-2022.
I'll make it.
First by David. Discussions or questions? Is there a second?
I'll make it.
Second by Kyle. All in favor? Motion passes 4-0. Next is approval of the 2021-2022 Walton Verona Technology Plan.
I'll make it.
First by Kyle. Discussions or questions? Is there a second?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
What was the, did we get all the computer stuff? Like, I'm just curious, like, how many were damaged? How many did we get back?
Yeah, there were, I think maybe 3 or 4 that didn't come back. One was stolen while the student was on vacation. Another one, students didn't return. And then thanks to the principals and Rob on a lot of them, we were able to contact families and eventually get most of them back. But still 3 or 4 that were gone.
Chargers, there's a lot of chargers still gone. But Bainan's been on that, and we've already got checks on our way.
Okay.
So, yeah.
I'm just curious how
that. Yeah, I think we did pretty good compared to some of the other school districts that I had spoken to.
Yeah.
We have a lot of good staff and good students, mm-hmm. and teachers keep up on it, principals keep up on it. So yeah, we were pretty good. I'm happy with what they did.
How many were damaged?
I think total for the year, I was at 64 that were damaged in some way.
Or did you get the last bit of it?
Yeah.
Like, okay.
Yeah.
Including middle school was the worst.
Yeah.
Okay. And not surprised by that. But.
Thanks.
Is there a second on that?
I'll make it.
Second by Stacy. All in favor?
Aye.
3. All opposed?
Aye.
Motion passes 3-1. Next is an approval to reject bids, the Walton Verona Elementary Paving 2021.
I'll make it.
First by David. Discussions or questions? there a second?
I'll make it.
Second by Kyle. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion passes 4-0. Next is approval to declare bus 15 as salvaged in accordance with the environmental mitigation plan for the Volkswagen settlement program.
I'll make it.
First by Kyle. Discussions, questions?
I just wanted to say, this is a little different than the normal surplus process. Like, we're not going to accept bids on this. It has to go, you know, what was the dollar amount? 20 grand?
I don't know. For this one,
yes.
It was close to 50.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. So all this was
awesome. This got Volkswagen.
Okay.
So, yeah, we've got to do it.
Okay. So, thank you. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Second by Stacy. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion passes 4-0. Next is approval of memorandum of agreement between Walton Reading Independent Schools and Thomas More University for programs and services available to school systems. First by Kyle. Discussions or questions? Is there a second?
I'll make it.
Second by David. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion passes 4-0. Next is the approval to enter into executive session pursuant to KRS 61.8101F.
I'll make it.
First by Kyle. Second?
I'll make it.
Second by Stacy. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion passes 4-0. We are in executive session. Okay, next is the approval to return to open session.
I'll make it.
First by Kyle. Discussions or questions? Is there a second?
I'll make it.
Second by David. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion passes 4-0. Next on the agenda is adjournment.
I'll make it.
First by Kyle. Is there a second? Second by Stacy, all in favor?
Aye.
Motion passes 4-0. We are adjourned at 8:51.